So clearly the shopping season has begun. These are some of the holiday sets that are out right now that I'm going to review for you so that you can see which is the best deal of all. Hi friends, yes, we do have a lot to get through, but they are mostly sets, so I'm going to get into this right now so that you can see out of like Sephora favorites or the lip combos that are at Ulta. I got some Anastasia Beverly Hills lippies in here, and I have a little bit of Tarte, which I don't normally ever review. I'm also going to really quickly show you, because I did haul this. This is from Morphe. This is the 35C Everyday Chic, and I haven't bought Morphe for quite some time. I do like their bigger palettes sometimes, but I was so drawn to this one. This one just has so many cool vibes in here, and I just absolutely was in love with what I saw. And what drew me so much to this is obviously these muted plums. This is a deepened plum. There's a lot lighter plums in here. You have the little bit of violet tones in here. You have the pinks, but you have some burgundies. You have a forest green up here. This just kind of ticks off a ton of boxes. I will say that a few of these shimmers are a little bit more sheer than I would like them to be. If I'm going to use a metallic, I want it to show up high metallic. So that was one little bit of a drawback. But most of them are gorgeous. One thing that I have noticed that you might like a lot from this palette is that even though some of these different shimmers are a little bit lighter, you might like that if you have an eyelid that you feel like you can't wear a lot of shimmer on, because what you might want to do is go in with a lighter color or a darker color, either one, and then put a topper over it. So pretty. The colors are beautiful on it. I have worked with it for 3 days now, and I just think that they're really gorgeous. I don't have a problem with any of them. Like I said, some of them come across. Shouldn't say I don't have a problem with any of them. I gotta stop. This one right here is a full-on glitter. So unless you're somebody that likes to wear glitter, you might not like that one. Doesn't bother me to have one in there. So just know that out of it. But I do think that these are really gorgeous. I think that they're beautiful, different colors, colors that we haven't seen out before from Morphe or really from anybody. I just think it's really a beautiful palette. I know that some people don't like Morphe at all, but I wanted to show that to you really quick. All right, on to the sets. I have to get my readers on for this because I want to read. So there's four in here, and they are pretty much just really super light colors. So if you're somebody that just really doesn't like a colored lip gloss, you just like look for toppers, this is perfect for you. So let me go through all of these. This first one is called Clouds. It is a very light colored pink with a little bit of a sheen of a peach in it. You're not gonna be able to see these hardly at all, but basically you know that they are just, more than anything, they're just toppers. This one is called Sweet. It looks like just a milky, super, super light vanilla in there. And again, you can't really see that. And then the next one is a super light nude, and this one is called Tasty. And they do smell really good. I like this one if you're somebody that really wants a really nude color to go over stuff. It's a very light nude on that. So these are all sheer, so you do know that as well. And then this last one is called Bubbly, and it has the little bit more of the reflect in it than any of the others do. Pretty much really sheer, but really beautiful at the same time, especially for a topper. So that is the set. Comes like this, and then, you know, you obviously get the little container that it comes in as well. So I do like that. I think it's a would be a great gift, especially if you have somebody that's young in your life. You know, sometimes the reds in sets can get a little bit carried away, and you don't want to see a young person in that, especially if they're under the age of about 14. So I really like this one a lot. And this one is $28 for the four of them. Okay, the next one is the one from Tarte. And again, this is the wardrobe, the blush wardrobe. Comes like this, so cool container on it. And then when you take it out, there's three individual, there's Ollie, there's three individual different palettes in here. And the palettes are actually kind of cool this time. I like that they didn't do them round. However, you open them up like this, there went a little cover. You open them up like this, you have a tiny little mirror up here, and then they do pivot around so you can see all the colors in here. So this particular one has kind of a champagne-y golden color in there, and then it has kind of a nude colored blush which is a little bit more on the deepened coral side. And then it has a bronzer in there. So that's what's in those three. So there's the first three in that little trio. And it has gold on the top. The next one has a rose gold on the top of it. And again, you have the highlighter there, which is more of almost a peachy highlighter in that one. And then a very peachy color underneath it for a blush. They said that all of these were new blush colors to Tarte. I do feel like this year with these, that's a little bit better than last year's. You know, last year they had the same concept, but it was round. And I didn't really like the quality of these in there as much as I do this year. So I do like this a little bit better this year. And then the last one has like a pinky lavender color on the top. And obviously, so that's going to give us a few more pink blushes in here. First one is like an iridescent. By the way, I should tell you, it said that there was one bronzer, two highlighters, and six new blushes, so that you know that. And then we have kind of a flat, like medium pink right here, or kind of a rose medium pink. Down here on the bottom is kind of a definite blue pink with a little bit more deepened on there. So I will put those across there so you can see them as well, if I can figure out where I was at. And there they all are. So personally, this time, I think that they did a pretty good job in picking out really nice colors and, you know, getting colors that would work for just about anybody. So I'm liking this gift set this time. Last year, I liked it, but I wasn't like crazy about it. I do think that they're pretty good quality this time. You know, lots of people say that usually in the sets, it's not as good a quality as it is in what you buy every day in their line. That very well may be true, but these were pretty good for me this time. And this gift set this time is $35 for the three little trios. So you're getting nine total products there for $35. All right, so this one is from Ulta, and this is the line lip line up. And then this one right here is $39 for all of these that you get in here. You get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 products in here, and you get a $5 off coupon that is good towards any of these that are full size. I will tell you that the Kylie lip gloss is a full size, and there was one other full size in here. I can't remember. It might be this nude stick right over here. I do think that that's actually pretty good as far as, you know, how much this would cost if you were to buy them separately. I will tell you that I was really loving this one from Grande Lips. But if you have been with me any amount of time, you know that I do not like grit. And when I put this on my lips, there was grit. And I was not happy, but man, oh man, that's pretty. So you get this mini from Lime Crime. This is just a clear gloss, and it's called Wet Cherry. So I'm assuming that it probably smells like cherries. It does have a fragrance in it, but I'm not exactly sure that that is cherry at all. And then you get over here from Buxom, you get a lip balm. It's just a teeny tiny little lip balm in there. You get a few lip colors in here. This one is from Bare Minerals, and I'll go ahead and I'll swatch that for you. This one is a red as well. Actually, this one, it almost looks like a light cherry red. It doesn't really look like a deepened one. And then Anastasia Beverly Hills, there's one in here. This looks like a medium nude color, which I think is really pretty. Actually, that looks almost like a medium mauve color, medium to deep mauve color. Ooh, that's pretty. I am gonna try that one on because I think that's pretty. Let's see, it probably won't show up too much over what I got on because I got so much going on my lips right now. I like that. It's very, very pretty color. It's a little bit more deepened. And then you get a little liquid lip from Smashbox. I'm assuming this is a little liquid lip. And this is kind of a, this is kind of a burnt orange color. And then this one is from Nude Stick. This is one of their lip crayons, which is really pretty. That is not a matte. That actually does have quite a bit of the satin or cream property to it. That's actually very pretty. More of kind of a neutral color. And then the Kylie lip gloss. What are you doing? Come on. Oh, goodness. So somebody wants to steal the limelight. He was over there whining. I don't know why. Those of you that don't know, this is Ollie, and now he is 4 months old, and he's getting so big. Do you guys remember when he was so tiny he could fit in my neck when I hugged him? Yeah, he's getting to be a big boy. And he's also a terrorist. He does all kinds of terrorist moves in the house. Terrorizes his sisters, terrorizes my laundry, terrorizes the garbage. He's pretty much your basic terrorist in all respects. So yeah, we're having all kinds of fun. Get a puppy, they said. It'll be fun, they said. But how can you stay mad at that face? So
He's a good boy.
He just is really, really busy. And so the last one that I have to share with you is the Kylie lip gloss. And this lip gloss is one that is just a perfect middle ground. It isn't too thick. It isn't too thin. I feel like you're going to have it there for a while. It's got a beautiful fragrance to it. I like that. It's a little bit of a vanilla soft fragrance to it. I like that. I actually did enjoy getting this one. All right, moving on to this Sephora favorite, which is the Lash Wardrobe, Mascara Wardrobe, Lash Stash. So it does come with 10 products in here. Now, one of them is the lashes, which I'll probably be sharing with my daughter because she loves lashes, but I might keep them for a special occasion. They're really pretty. They're the Velour lashes, and I've heard that they're really nice lashes. It also comes with the Lancôme Definisils. This one is the primer. And if you guys have never seen this before, it is a great primer. It does a really good job of helping to thicken and lengthen those lashes. And it does have little fibers in it. And it doesn't really, if you don't let it dry down completely, if you let it dry down completely, you're not going to like it. But if you go in when it's still a little bit tacky and put your other mascara on top of it, you're going to really like that. Now, it does have the full size of the Blink mascara and the full size of the Pat McGrath mascara. I really wanted to try this one from Urban Decay because it's that new one with that funky wand. However, I will tell you that I've already tried that, and that is the goopiest, nastiest mess, and I probably won't be using that. But what I might do is when I'm done with some of these others, if the wand fits in here, I might just test the formula of it because I think the wand is just a little wonky for me. But it does come with some that I know that I absolutely love. Bad Gal Bang from Benefit. Really, really beautiful mascara for length and volume. And then this one is one from Ilia. I think that's how you say it. Anyway, this one gives the most phenomenal length. I was just so impressed on that. And then the one from Anastasia Beverly Hills. I actually have this one on today. So can you see my lashes, ladies? I love this one. It feels really soft on the lashes. It doesn't feel crunchy. The Better Than Sex one, it's okay. I've tried it in the past. I don't think it's the best mascara in the world. I probably will be passing that on in a giveaway or maybe to my daughter. But overall, I was really excited about these choices this year. There's a lot of new stuff in here. There's a lot of tried and true, like the Lancôme primer. I love that. I really do think they're good. Oh, by the way, this one is from Grande Lash, and this one is their serum. So you get that in there too. I don't use this one, so again, I'm going to be passing that on to somebody else. I use my own serums. If you want to know what that is, I'll make sure I link it down below. I'll make sure I see if I can throw it up in a card. You know what? When YouTubers say they're going to throw something up in a card, never believe it, because we usually always forget we're going to throw it up in the card. I do think this is a great deal at $48 for what they gave you in there, because even just a little tiny mascara like this can run you $13 or $14, and these big ones from Pat McGrath, $30. So, you know, you're getting a really good deal there. All right, the last one that I have to share with you is the Makeup Must-haves from Sephora Favorites. I'm sharing these with you because these won't last until, you know, holiday shopping that kicks off on Black Friday. These mostly will be gone because people know that these are actually pretty good sets. Now, this one has in it 2, 4, 6, 8 products. And the Marc Jacobs is a full size, the NARS is a full size, and the Huda Beauty is a full size, along with the Anastasia Brow, I think that's the Brow Wiz. Yes. So that's a full size as well. This is packed full of some of my very favorites of all time. I am not going to dip into the NARS blush, but I will show you that it is the full size one there. I'm going to save that for a giveaway, but this is the NARS Orgasm blush that is in there, and it's a beautiful blush. If you've never seen it, it's just kind of a pinky peachy one with a tiny bit of a sheen that goes so pretty across the skin. It can be built up, it can be sheared out. It is a cult favorite for a reason. It's really good. And then also in here is the Photo Finish. This is the primer from Smashbox. This is who started it all with primers. And this is just your basic dimethicone primer that fills pores. It's a little bit of a medium to thick formula, but man, this blurs out pores. Going in through this area for me is just fantastic with this. Again, this was my own that I already have, so I didn't touch this one in here. The Huda Beauty lipstick, I will swatch that one for you so you can see what color it is. I think this is really pretty. It is definitely a very, very matte color. I would say that this color is a medium warm rose on it. Some of the tried and true products that are in here is the Urban Decay All Nighter. Everybody that uses this one understands why it's called that. If you have oily skin, combo skin, if you get combo through your T-zone, then spray it in your T-zone. Your makeup's gonna last like crazy. If you have oily skin, it is also going to help keep that oil at bay all day long. And it's great to have these ones that you can throw in your purse and either travel with or, you know, just have every day when you got your little makeup bag in your purse. The Anastasia Brow Wiz, on one side it has a spoolie on one side, and then on the other side it has just the very, very fine tipped micro brow. And let me get the spectacles so we can see what color this one is. This is probably taupe, medium brown. And it is a pretty brown. It's a little bit on the warm side, I will tell you. Let me see if I can build that up. But you know what? It really, I don't know, it kind of is casting neutral. So I like that one a lot. And then it has the Kat Von D, or the KVD, not called Kat Von D anymore, tattoo liner that again is a cult classic. And I have had that one for years. Love it. So good. It's a really good one. I have not tried the Pat McGrath before on the mascara. I'm not going to crack that one open because I want to save it, because I have so many already opened from the Lash Wardrobe over there. And so I'm not going to open that one yet, but it also has the Peach Perfect. This is the peach smelling powder from Too Faced. And you guys know I'm not crazy about Too Faced as a brand, but it was in here and I wasn't going to pass up all those other goodies. So this one we will see, because I've never tried it before either. It feels really good. Feels really nice. It feels a lot like the Laura Mercier Translucent Setting Powder, but it does have that little bit of artificial peach scent in it. So you know that. Okay, so that is that whole one right there. Here's what I feel about some of these. I think that you could break them apart, take out of them what you haven't tried yet or what you want to try, and then gift them to somebody that you like, or just keep it all together and keep it as a gift for yourself or pass it on to somebody else. But I do feel like they put together some really great gift sets this year. I usually almost always get the Anastasia little four sets because I just love these glosses. The glosses are not too sticky, but they are a little bit thicker of a formula so that you will have the gloss on all day long, which I think is great. So yeah, let me know in the comment section if you guys are trying anything yet, if you've gotten anything yet, if this is something that you do pick up every year. I try to pick up one or two, especially to review them for you guys, but I wanted to make sure that I brought them to you as soon as I could, because like I said, they are gone really quickly early in the year, way before Black Friday usually. So if you see something you like, maybe jump on it. And we do know that Sephora is going to be having their sale pretty soon. I think I'm VIB this year, so I only get like 15% off, but it's a little bit of something. Anyway, that is it. I hope that you guys have enjoyed this video. Please give it a thumbs up if you have. I really do appreciate that, and I hope everybody is doing really well. I know that we're in the middle of another surge with COVID. Oh my goodness. So wear your mask, sanitize, wash those hands, stay out of really crowded places, because honestly, people, my mother and dad got it from passing keys. So my sister-in-law didn't know she had it. She passed keys through a doorway, just the keys. And when my mother touched the keys, it was on there. And that's how my mother and dad got it. So be vigilant, people. Use the sanitizer and definitely, definitely wash those hands and wear those masks. So love you all very much. Catch you all in my next video. Bye, guys.